Hello, Mysterious Internaut. This is IkeyBoy71's, my moniker online, the Underwear Magician. I've been doing something of trying to get involved in all this for a while now, and I watched your video on I'm an Atheist One, and very convincing arguments. I'm actually quite impressed and glad that you're doing this. However, I had to point out a couple of things which I thought were a little bit off. One is the quantum vacuum argument, as I wrote in a comment on your website, on your video. That quantum vacuum argument is, I mean, the data is correct, we know that. However, that same argument has also been used by New Agers to promote the existence of God in such films as What the Bleep Do We Know? So I would avoid using that, basically, because of the fact that religious people could start picking you apart based on that. It's just, you know, just my own personal, suggestion about how to argue for atheism. Like I said, argument's great, just more, methods as opposed to anything else. The other thing is the many worlds theory of quantum mechanics. Again, I am a chemistry student. You know, university level. And myself, I personally don't like arguing any one of particular theories about quantum mechanics, like interpretations as examples for why or why not God does not exist, because of the fact that the transactional interpretation, the many worlds interpretation, and the Copenhagen interpretation are just that, interpretations. We have no or little to, or next to no actual scientific data, as quite a few other people commented, to be able to actually prove the existence one way or the other. So, it's great that we can use interpretations to support initial points, but I prefer not to argue for, I prefer to work on facts for arguing the existence of God or the existence of anything, as opposed to hypothesis, speculation, you know what I mean? Like, and that's part of the reason why, too, I've got a large problem with the paranormal right now as well, because what we have is we have very little data, we have even quite a lot of data from both sides, but there's a couple of major flaws, and we don't have enough data on that, on those particular flaws on both sides of the argument. I sent you a personal message about the article pertaining to the experimenter effect, which has been having a psi believer finding a phenomena and a psi believer and a psi skeptic not. And I know the article dismisses the whole thing about the subconscious anomalous, the subconscious detection of psychic staring, but nonetheless, if it were a normal phenomena, both a skeptic and a psi believer should have found it, and there should not have been any problem with it. If a skeptic's not finding a phenomena which is supposed to be normal and outside the field of psi, we still have a serious problem here. So, and if that stretches all across psi, then psi research, then again, we still have a major problem, and we need to address that before we can even go further in looking at the paranormal in general, let alone religion. So, yeah, needless to say, I'm a little bit PO'd. Now, at the same time, if you look at my profile, I put up an ESP test and some retropsychokinesis stuff. I said before, please, do send back critique. I would very much appreciate it for, looking at experimental flaws. And it's only for data gathering, because of the fact that I have, I don't know what else to do with it. I'm just simply trying to present data and allowing people to be the judge. But I digress. Main point two, again, great argument. Like I said, convincing argument, but again, working off hypotheses, not off, it's a hypothesis, it's not actual data or evidence. And I also left you a message, and I'm repeating what I wrote to you in the personal message, but this is for the YouTube viewers in general. Basically, I wrote about a snake skeleton having been found with hip bones. Interestingly enough, in your video on keeping faith out of schools, there's been all these worries about creationism, and granted, I don't agree with creationism either. I think the science on that one is bunk, and I personally can't stand people who promote creationism because they are deliberately duping people on science. At the same time, I also can't stand magicians like Penn and Teller who deliberately misuse, who deliberately misrepresent stuff like global warming in science, but I digress again. Bottom line, I think that there has been, and and also I'm now going to quote a part where religion and science actually compare. If you actually use two particular parts of scripture from the Bible, both of which were quoted in the Shope's monkey trial in 1920s in Tennessee, the sun was not created till the fourth day in the book of Genesis, and 2nd Epistle of Peter chapter 3 verse 8 says, "But a thousand years is but a day or a watch in thy sight, Lord," depending on the translation. And if you intersect that, if you combine that, if you take that and the order of which the animals were created in the book of Genesis, match that with what we currently know of evolution and put in the time dilation factor, you could have 4.5 billion years of an evolved universe, and 4.5 billion years of an evolved planet, and that amount of time for evolution. So, you know, perhaps maybe some early on guy got the idea, hey, wait a second, maybe evolution existed, but got it in such vague terms he was a little bit ahead of his time. I mean, after all, Pythagoras got ideas for mathematics ahead of his time. You know, it's not that hard to figure out. Another example is the fact that a couple of million years ago, there was a snake skeleton with hip bones which got fossilized and got found about a year ago, according to the Discovery Channel news show Daily Planet. So yeah, there's some stuff arguing for religion as well as equally for against. And like I said before, we have data on both sides, equal amounts from the look of it. We have a lot of hypotheses, interpretation, speculation, but we don't have anything definitive, or at least anything definitive enough that we can properly discuss with. So bottom line, my own personal belief is that I'm going to believe, because of the fact that I've seen some very good replicated studies right now on the paranormal, I'm leaning towards the belief of the paranormal for now. In terms of religion, I'm kind of keeping the same way because of this sort of thing. But nonetheless, I'm going to not label myself an agnostic, and I'm going to stay an agnostic until we've actually got something more definitive in the data perspective that we can actually discuss. You know, that we can, you know, that we've got some data on these quantum mechanics interpretations, the data on this parapsych phenomena. You know, so this way we can actually start, okay, let's pick apart the New Agers and Atheists arguments, and skeptical arguments. Let's actually do something with it, not just, you know, speculate, throw beliefs about willy-nilly, use ad hoc arguments on both sides. So that's just my own particular section on it. We have to get more data, and we have, you know, until we can actually discuss it. So I basically, in sum up, basically the whole argument of whether or not there is a God at this point, I'm pretty, you know, until we've got some more conclusive data, is moot. Sorry, but that's just my own thoughts. Take it for what you will. Anyway, I enjoyed the Doctor Who videos. Keep up the good work with the atheist arguments, and believers, keep up your good arguments too, and, you know, we'll sooner or later get this thing debated and solved one way or another for, once and for all. Okay, bye-bye.